To create your first mesh model, you need to click on the Create Mesh Model button along the top toolbar. This brings up the Create Mesh Model dialog box. Next, choose your scanner type. So in this case, we're using a BLK2GO. And then for the BLK2GO, you need to set the filtering level that was used when you were creating the point cloud file. If you don't know, then high is a good bet, but you can always reprocess it later at a lower level of detail if you need to. Alternatively, if you're using your own data, then you just need to pick the scanner and pick the level of detail that you actually need. It's important to only pick the level of detail that you actually need for the project, because with more detail comes more data size, and so ultimately you could be adding unnecessary file size and processing time to the process when you actually don't need it. So I'm going to flip back to BLK2GO. We use the high filtering settings, so some filtering, but not reducing the points too much, and press OK. The software will go away and create a segmented mesh model. The meshing process happens in three stages. First, the software will assign points to tiles. This is usually the fastest stage. The second stage, converting tiles, is usually the longest stage. During this stage, the software is converting small tiles of point clouds into small tiles of meshes. The final stage, called creating super tiles, is assembling those small meshes back into a larger model. The number of super tiles being created depends on the size of the data and the level of detail that you've meshed to. Once the meshing process is finished, the mesh will be delivered into the Mesh Models folder within the Scan group in the Project Explorer. For big models, you might find that multiple meshes are delivered for a single point cloud. These are what we call super tiles, and these are how PointFuse deals with processing at scale. So before we go any further, let's take a look at what makes this PointFuse mesh unique. So first of all, I'm going to right click to access some additional viewing tools and switch on the wireframe. As you can see, PointFuse has produced a very efficient mesh with big triangles representing the hundreds of points of the large flat surfaces. But where there's extra detail, like around the light fixtures, triangulation becomes much smaller. You can also see lines in the mesh model. These are created by the tiles. As I mentioned previously, when PointFuse is producing its mesh models, it's going to chop the point cloud up into tiles, convert them all, and then assemble them back together at the end. If I quickly hold Control and select on a surface, the other unique factor is that this surface is separate to this surface, to this surface, to this surface, and that makes everything selectable. So we'll come on to classification in some more detail later. Finally, if I switch the wireframe off and use the option in this toolbar here to switch the RGB on, the software uses the RGB values of the points to colorize the point cloud.